Hello and welcome to History Pod. On the 10th of February 1906, the British King, Edward VII, launched HMS Dreadnought. This revolutionary new type of battleship made all other ships obsolete. Ever since the British government adopted the two-power standard as part of the 1889 Naval Defence Act, the Royal Navy had been required to have at least the same number of battleships as the next two largest navies in the world, combined. By 1906, Wilhelm II of Germany had begun aggressive military expansion, including the construction of battleships, to pursue the development of a German empire under his world policy, or Weltpolitik. German naval expansion put pressure on Britain to increase the size of its own navy. At the time of her launch, HMS Dreadnought was the fastest and most heavily armed ship in the world, and the name Dreadnought began to be used to describe a whole new class of similar ships. Although possessing the singularly most powerful ship in the world should, theoretically, have made Britain the undisputed champion of the seas, the launch of the Dreadnought was problematic. In particular, the new battleship caused problems for Britain's two-power standard, because the country now only possessed one more Dreadnought-class ship than every other country in the world. With all other ships obsolete in the wake of the new design, it was now far too easy for other countries to catch up. Germany quickly began developing an equivalent ship, and launched the first of its Nassau vessels in 1908. This, in turn, forced Britain to keep ahead by building more and more Dreadnought-class ships in line with the demands of the two-power standard. This naval arms race and the tension that followed was a major contributing factor to the outbreak of the First World War in 1914.